Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Charleston, and welcome you guys to another episode of the Dreamerspro Show, where we cover everything from sports, hot topics, classic debates, and entertainment, and where we give you guys a fresh perspective on things and how we see them. And we have an interesting episode here for you guys here today, so please make sure you go and like the video and subscribe to the channel. I know some of you guys are like, man, more Kobe content. Yeah, man, more Kobe content. You know, we're trying to change the, narrative. You know, ever since I've been following basketball, and I had to sit back for so many years and watch Kobe just get slandered. And I'm like, man, if I ever had a voice in the future, I would do something to try to reverse some of the stuff that they've done. And as a Kobe fan, sometimes I sit back and I listen to various voices in the media disrespect his legacy. And I just sit there scratching my head like, you know, what is going on? And it became something that became so standardized that now, even when you talk about the top five players in NBA history, if you mention Kobe to some people, like, no, he's not. Like, they automatically, summarily just dismiss him, right? And I'm not saying that Kobe Bryant has to be your favorite player of all time, your top two, top three, none of that, top four. But the fact that a lot of people try to scoff at the notion that he should be in the top five, and then they have other guys in their top fives with similar resumes, and you're like, wait a minute, what's the difference with you know, with this guy? Like, it's just to me, it's just you know, it's just crazy. Now, ever since the announcement of the Redeem Team Olympics documentary that's actually being put together by LeBron James and Dwayne Wade, ever since the announcement of that, which will drop next month, we've finally been hearing various voices and sources and media coming out there to really talk about Kobe Bryant in a positive way, but really just say the truth about him. Just yesterday, I saw a video that was put together by the YouTube channel called, Free Dawkins. And it was centered on that 2008 Olympic team. And they were basically highlighting the contribution and the importance of having Kobe Bryant on that team. And this latest report that we're about to get to, I believe, is another example of why Kobe Bryant is absolutely a top five player of all time. We're actually getting this article here. From Fadeaway? Yeah, fadeawayworld.net. So I want to get into it here. It's a pretty interesting read. Basically, the article starts off with the headline, Kobe Bryant used to take 40-mile bike rides in the desert to motivate LeBron James and the 2012 Team USA. And then the article basically continues on. Kobe Bryant was always trying to inspire people both on and off the court. And there was no better example to do so than himself. Kobe would put his body through some intense workouts and routines to get better and show people why hard work always pays off. The Black Mamba was one of the fiercest competitors in NBA history, constantly working on his game, trying to be the best player he could season after season. Even during the summer, Kobe was relentless, trying to find new ways to improve his game and best his rivals. He also used the moments to inspire those who looked up to him, including his own teammates. During the summer of 2012, Kobe was with Team USA, ready to represent the country again and defend the gold medal they won in 2008 with the Redeem Team. Kobe wanted to set the tone and found a big way to do it. The old story from Ramona Shelburne basically says, Blake Griffin needs to know if the story is true. Ever since he first heard of it last July, he's been obsessed with it. The first night we all got into Las Vegas last summer for USA basketball camp, I heard Kobe Bryant went on some 40-mile bike ride at night through the desert, Griffin says. 40 miles at night? You think it's true? Before I can answer, Griffin continues, when I found out about that bike ride, I was so tempted to ask if I could go next time. The ESPN reporter shed light on the story, recalling how Kobe and his trainer, Tim Grover, came up with a big plan to add bike rides to Kobe Bryant's workout routine. The story Griffin heard turns out to be true, and it goes something like this. Bryant told a longtime trainer, Tim Grover, that he wanted to add in bike training to his summer conditioning. Grover researched a trail in Las Vegas, rented three bikes, one for Kobe Bryant, one for himself, and Kobe Bryant security. And on the night before the first day of practice, they each put on headlamps and headed out for a trail on the road. We finished up around 2 a.m., Grover said, and we were back in the gym working out by 7:30 a.m. in the morning. So you heard what that story had to say there. And to be honest with you guys, none of this really surprises me whatsoever, right? This is not the first time I'm hearing something like this. And as a matter of fact, Dwayne Wade, who was a teammate of Kobe Bryant on that team, he also gave an incredible story about Kobe Bryant. And that's why I think it's just funny when people are talking about that Dwayne Wade was better than Kobe or even on his level. So what we want to do is play what Dwayne Wade had to say about Kobe Bryant, a workout that he witnessed back in 2008. So we're going to play that for you guys and come back. So take a listen to that.
And this is when I knew Kobe was a monster, though. You hear about it. You hear about it. But you really, if you don't see it, you really, really don't know. And so we get into a city, one of the cities very late. And immediately we all go to the gym. You know, all my guys, it's, you know, it's Melo, it's B, it's Bron, it's Kobe. Like, we all go to the gym. We all get our work in. It's real late. And so after we get done getting our work in, me and my guys, we say, hey, like, let's meet for breakfast in the morning. Like, if you can't sleep, whoever first one wake up, hit us up. We're going to go eat. And so we do that. We probably get like 3 hours of sleep. You can't sleep much when you're traveling across the world, you know, like we were traveling. And we get probably get like 3 hours of sleep. And we wake up, we go down to where the food is. And as we walk it down, you know, slubbing with sleep in our eyes, Kobe Bryant is sitting there with ice on his knees already, right? So we walk up to Kobe, we like, Kobe, what's up? And he was like, yeah, man, I just finished the workout and I'm about to go do another one. And at that moment, I was like, wait, hold on. We just worked out about 3 hours ago. You know what I mean? And like, you've done another workout and you're about to go do another one. That's when I was like, okay, I got to get my stuff together. I got to get my shit together. Because this dude right here is on a whole different level than even I'm on. And I'm supposed to be great, right? So that's the kind of person he was. And that's how he drove me. You know what I mean? Like, just little stuff like that. I went back and said, okay, that means I got to work hard and I got to do more. So yeah, I just wanted to share that little anecdote.
That's great. So you heard what Dwayne Wade had to say. Now, does that sound like Kobe Bryant was trying to get on Dwayne Wade's level? I recently heard a comment from a guy saying, oh, you capping for Kobe. You really, really, really capping for Kobe, man. Kobe wasn't really that good. Like, he wasn't all of that. Dwayne Wade was better than Kobe. Did that sound like Dwayne? Did Dwayne Wade sound like somebody? Did he sound like somebody that was better than Kobe? Was he talking about this guy like as if he was better than him? He said, I needed to get on his level, right? Which brings me to my larger point, and I have a few of them. The first one is, what these people have been telling you about Kobe Bryant is absolutely not true. That Kobe was never the best player. He never inspired players. His work ethic wasn't head and shoulders above all of this stuff these people have been saying is just a bunch of lies, man. They just trying to fit narratives because somebody been tapping in pockets. That's what I believe. That's what I believe. I don't have proof of it, but that's what I believe. You say one thing one day, the next day you're saying something different. I'm like, wait a minute. What happened, bro? Like, what happened? What happened? So, to me, that's the one thing I feel about that. But here's a larger message that I want you guys to take away from all of this. Kobe Bryant, I believe his biggest mark on the world will be the mama mentality. And it's really centered on hard work, right? Really, that's at the heart of it all, right? Hard work, mental toughness, grit, all of those things. And I think that that's what people can get can learn from him. Instead of being a hater, why don't you learn something from the guy? Instead of being a hater, how about that? Instead of being a hater, why don't you try to pick up some of the things about this guy that made him great? And maybe it can make you great in your life. How about that? How about we stop looking at him from the angle of, oh, I'm a hater. Kobe Bryant shot 46% from the field, whatever it is. And look at the impact that he had on the world and on his peers. These are his peers talking about him. To me, I think the biggest lesson you can take away from this story, apart from all the lies that these jokers out here have been telling, is that hard work matters and it pays off eventually. Eventually, it will pay off. That's the message here. And I think that should be the takeaway from all of this. So whatever you guys think, please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section. And we catch you all on the next episode. Peace.